What is going on, everyone? Yesterday, Stephen dropped the quarterly creative director's letter for Ashes of Creation, going over all sorts of things about the next couple months and the build-up to Alpha 1 in June. Starting off with what everyone wants to hear. This May, Alpha 1 buy-ins will be returning for those who missed out on it. And the people who want to drop a hefty amount of money and help test the game will have a chance to do so. Which, there does seem to be a lot more people now supporting the game, especially since some big streamers last summer started talking about it when Steven dropped that 4K footage. Although we don't know the full details on this yet, we are expecting to hear more on this at the end of the month, but Steven made clear in the letter, if you're expecting to get into Alpha 1 to play a finished game, do not buy in. They want testers. The game is far from complete and is expected to have lots of bugs that need squashing. Not every feature is implemented and the ones that are won't even be complete. So if you're not in it for testing, you probably shouldn't spend your money on it. If you have bought an Alpha 2 pack, well, Steven has said in the Discord that you will have the ability to upgrade this to an Alpha 1 pack. What other perks come with this, if any, along with the cost is unknown as of now, but last time Alpha 1 was up for grabs, it was around $500, I believe, to get the bundle. And if you don't have any bundles, you can always, you know, check out my referral link, create an account, and go buy one. In other news, Intrepid is trying real hard to get Sieges into Alpha 1. It is not set in stone yet, but they have been importing the code from the Apocalypse Siege engine, and it is possible we will be getting a basic siege system to attack some castles or nodes during the Alpha 1 testing, which could be pretty awesome to see. But again, don't get your hopes up just yet. Even if this gets in, it won't be close to the final rendition or even what we are going to see for Sieges in Alpha 2, but it will give you a feel for a nice large-scale battle in the game. Intrepid is also planning to be moved into their new studio by June 15th to hopefully get back to a bit of normalcy within the development process. And lastly, in the letter, we got three never-before-seen concept arts, the first one being my favorite, which takes us deep into what appears to be a dwarven mine. Unknown to us if this is a raid, a node, or something more, but it seems to be a cool place to set out and explore, and I'd love to have dwarven nodes head deep within the side of a mountain. The next photo appears to be an elven-themed throne room. Again, the context behind this is unknown. It could be a throne to a castle, as guild leaders whom own castles will be titled kings and queens, but it could also be the seat of a powerful foe in a dungeon or raid. The last concept art piece we get is what appears to be the entrance to some dwarven architecture leading into the mountain. This could possibly even be the entrance to that dwarven mine we saw earlier. It is hard to say, but it is a pretty cool looking piece. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this short video. If you want to check out the full creative director's letter, well, link is in the description below. Otherwise, be sure to click that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up, turn on the bell for notifications, and stay tuned for a lot more to come.